The box joints on my lidded box are next. I've got my box joint jig on here. I actually modified my half inch box joint jig to make it cut 3/8 joints. I'll put the link in the description of how I make this jig. I've got it dialed in. I tried it on some poplar first, and then I had a little walnut kicking around here, and it took a while to dial this in. But I'm real happy with the fit now. It's a little on the snug side, which is fine. I don't want it too snug, because when I get glue on it, it's going to be difficult to put together. But I think that's a nice fit. I've got my parts marked, so where I'm going to start on each one, the top and bottom parts. And I should point out, you know, I would typically, if I'm making a box, make the whole box and then cut the top off. But for a couple reasons on this box, I've decided to make the top and bottom separate. Now, I may regret that, but I think I'll be okay and I can tweak things if I need to. The reasons I decided to make the top and bottom separate are, one, I wanted the box joints to continue from the top to the bottom. If I made the box and then cut it, I'd have an 1/8 inch gap where my kerf is. The other thing is, you know, the bottom has dividers, and, you know, I don't want the dados for the dividers to go through the bottom, not through the top. I'm ready to get started here, so we'll start cutting some box joints. Okay, the bottom is done. Turned out great. Everything fits nice and tight. You know, I didn't miss any in terms of, you know, having the piece, you know, not quite parallel or perpendicular. It's easy when you've got the parts there to have one side up or down and then not cut quite as deep. Also note that, you know, I've got my triangle marking on here to keep track of what part goes where. So I'm going to do the top next. Now the top's going to be just a little different in that this piece is pretty narrow and it's not supported very well on here. So I'm going to use one of my stop blocks to make sure that it is perpendicular to the base, and that should keep me aligned when I'm doing that. Okay, I've got the top done now, and I realized as I was cutting that I really lucked out here, because when I was doing this cut, this piece is not supported over here. It's so narrow that it totally falls into this gap, and it's only supported by the finger here. Now, fortunately, and this is where I got lucky, this finger is the exact height of this cut. So the board is supported at the right height, even though it's not touching my sled here. So, you know, once in a while you get lucky on these things and things work out. So this does fit together nicely. I line things up here. Yeah, I think you can see here that the you know, the depth of cut on both of those is the same. Like I said, once in a while you get lucky. Maybe I should go buy a lottery ticket. Okay, next we'll do the groove for the top and bottom. And before I leave here, I just put this together. I just want to show how it looks like the finger joints go all the way through here. if I had, you know, made the top or made the whole box as one piece and then cut this apart, I wouldn't easily be able to do that unless I removed a full 3/4 inch of the top or bottom in order to make that happen. So that's why, that's the big reason I did these as separate pieces. I've got the router set up now. I've got an 1/8 inch bit in there, which is pretty small. And I've got it up 3/32 seconds approximately. I'm going to go in 3/16. And I've got it set. I don't know if you can see this, a little dark here, but so it just misses this first finger, which is where I have it on my drawing. I've got these set up so my marks, this is the top of the top. I want that against here. And on the bottom parts, I want the bottom, which is, you know, this, my triangle marks are on the top. So I want to make sure that I'm routing on the other side, the bottom. And I've got the parts set like that. I'm doing the through grooves first because that's easier. The other parts are going to get stopped grooves. So I'll just run these through each once, raise the bit up to the full depth and do it again. I would normally cut 3/16 in one pass, but this bit is so small, it's a little on the fragile side, so I'm going to do it in two passes. All right, that went fine. Looks good. I just missed the bottom finger there. Actually, a little closer than I was expecting, but I missed it, so that's fine. So I'll set up now for the stopped cut. Now, I should say I ran these through twice because typically, particularly for smaller grooves, the chips get stuck in there. A little hard to get out even if you bang on this. So I ran through a second time each time just to clear things out. To set up for the stopped cut, I need to know where the bit stops and starts because I'm not going to be able to see the bit. So I've turned the bit so the carbide is parallel to the fence, and I've loosened up my fence pieces here. I'm going to put just this up against the bit and then align these so that they're even with the end there. So now I know exactly where the bit's cutting. I'll tighten these up. Okay, I've got this lined up here. So what I'm gonna do with the bit running, and I've lowered it back down to half depth, I'm gonna drop this down on here. Yeah, I'm not gonna put a line. It's not that critical as long as I'm at least halfway into the finger there. So I'll drop it down. Go to the other end, back up a little bit, lift up, and I'll do that for both depths of cutter and should be set with these next parts. Next, I need to cut the plywood, the top and bottom pieces to size. So I've put together the bottom part of the box here. I measured the inside dimensions. They are about 1/32 smaller than the plan, which is fine. The depth of my grooves is 3/16 each. So I'll take this dimension, add 3/8 to that. I'm going to subtract off a 16, or no, probably subtract off an 1/8. So I have a 1/16 gap all the way around on the inside. And I'll cut my plywood to that size. Now, this is pretty symmetric in terms of its pattern. You know, it's, you know, when they make this stuff, they book match it. So for the top, since the top's going to be visible, I'm going to take the piece out from here as opposed to here, because this gets a little more cathedrally over here. So just to make the pattern symmetric on the top, I'm going to do that. For the bottom, I'm just going to move over here just to save an extra piece. No one's going to see the bottom. I don't care about that. But I do want the top to look as nice as I can. So I'll cut that out. And then I'm going to cut a rabbet around the edge so that this plywood, which is somewhere between 3/16 and a quarter inch thick, will fit in this eighth inch groove. So that's how I'm going to deal with this being a little thicker than my plan. Okay, I did my measurements, did the math, and the width of my plywood is 10 and a 16th. The length is 12 and 5/16. And just as a sanity check, I like to, you know, make sure my numbers are good here. So I'm gonna start at 10. I don't like starting at the zero there. It's a little hard to tell where I'm at. I'm gonna start at 10 and put my thumb at 20 and a 16th. So that's obviously 10 and a 16th from there, and see if that looks correct. And it does. And then of course I'll do it for the other direction too. And I'll go ahead and cut the plywood then. I've got the plywood cut to size now. I've got the bit set up. I used an offcut to make sure it's set correctly. So I'm leaving an eighth of an inch so it fits in the groove. I've come in a little over a quarter of an inch, so I'll see a little reveal around the inside edge, top and bottom. The interior of this plywood is poplar, so it's probably not going to stain the same as the face veneer. So I'll probably just color it black, take a felt pen, make it black. So I'll have a black shadow line around the central section here. So I'll go ahead and route this. I'm going to route the end grain first because I might get a little tear out here, and then that tear out will get cut off when I do the go with the grain. Okay, that turned out good. I think I can show this here. I've got it centered in here. So you can see I've got a little shadow line around there. And, you know, of course, that's going to set in here like that. So on the top of the top, you'll see that shadow line. Like I said, I'll make it black. And before I glue it up, I want to stain these pieces. I don't want to try and stain them once they're in place. So I'm going to stop this video here, get these things stained and ready to glue up. And then the next video, I'll glue up and put the hardware on, finish things up.